Hello again. I'm back. I told you yesterday that I would come back and do some trick steps for musical theater and a little bit of partnering. So we'll do a little, cha-cha, a little waltz, and a little bit of Charleston, and a little bit of swing, okay? So before we do that, I'm just gonna give you some, just a couple of stretches that I know that sometimes you theater people stretch just your, I guess your, you know, vocal cords, things like that. You warm that part up, but you don't really warm up like you should if you're gonna go out. I mean, dancers, if they're gonna go out and do a dance show, they're gonna warm up for an hour. So I'm just gonna give you a couple of things, you know, but, okay. So you could grab a chair for this, and I'm just gonna use the countertop out in the kitchen. But one of the very first things that you could do that's a great stretch is to warm up your Achilles and your hamstrings. So if you just hold on to something and take your, I'm taking my right foot forward, okay, so that I'm gonna be in a lunge. And I'm gonna get kind of deep here and I'm gonna push forward, all right? Really pushing forward. So what I'm doing is I'm stretching out the inside of my left quad, okay? My left thigh. Okay, so I'm pushing. Then I'm gonna just reverse that and stretch back. And when I do that, I'm lifting my toe, all right? So now I'm really getting this stretch, and this is my favorite stretch. And, you know, we usually say you should go to a flat back. So a flat back is when your back is completely out flat. It's not rounded up or it's not concaved in, that it's flat. So you would be like this for that stretch. So you'd rotate forward, get back into your deep lunge. Okay, and then rotate that back to the flat back. And then you take that on your left side. So I'm gonna put my left foot front and lunge forward. Well, you can really feel that on the inside of your leg that you're in the lunge on, the front leg. Really push and then pull back into your flat back. And then again, push forward. And then pull back, okay? Actually, I'll put a little music on because I'm kind of boring to listen to. So I'll just put something quiet and pretty on. Yeah. Okay. So then after we've done that, we hang onto the chair and we pull with both feet together, all right? So that I'm actually like this. All my weight is going back, okay? So I'm really pulling back over my heels. There's no weight forward. Then I reverse that and arch backwards. So keep your heels on the floor. When you're pushing forward, make sure your heels stay on the floor and really push back. Okay, and then pull back again. And then push back in again. Okay, great. Okay, then just take your legs apart. Take your right leg, twist it in and out. In and out. In and out. And in and out. This is just a good loosening up. In and out. In and out, in and out, in and out. Then legs apart, reach way out with this arm, side stretch over, up, change, all the way over. You can go all the way parallel to the floor and open, and again, side stretch over, and up, and reverse that, side stretch over, and up, and then drop your head down, side, back. Drop down, side, circle back, and side. Then I reverse it, drop to the side. See how just loose your body just hangs through this? Don't tighten anything up, just hang loose. And back, and then let's tilt. Side, up, side, and up. Inside and up, side and up. Let's drop forward, drop forward and up, drop back and up. Now double time that, down and back and down and back. And then shoulders. Pick up those shoulders, pull them back, pick them up, pull them back. I'm gonna go faster. One, two, three, four. Other way, up, pull back, up, pull back a little faster. One, two, three, four. And you can swing your arms and swing and swing and swing a little quicker. Swing, 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 swing. This is just getting long, your air in your lungs. And then the final one is stretch up. Let's go forward. Okay, let all your weight drop down. Drop all the way down and round up. Okay, so you could do that a couple of times. And then I usually do some kicks. Usually, when's the last time I was on stage, right? In a show. But I used to grab a chair or grab anything backstage and just swung my legs front and back. See how I'm bending them? Just let them stay bent. Okay, and then later you can swing them straight front and back, okay? Do it the left leg. It does not matter if you're not great at kicks or anything. It just loosens everything up in your hips, okay? So I think when you're nice and loose to go out on stage, you know, you're ready to go, right? You're in fighting mode. Okay, so we're gonna start with some tricks. Okay, so the first trick, and by the way, all these tricks are probably from vaudeville. So if you're young and you don't know what vaudeville is, call Brandon. He'll explain it to you. Brandon, I hope you're up doing these, by the way. Okay, so we're gonna start with the scissors, okay? So it's called scissors because it looks like a scissors. Closed, open, closed, open. So you go step to the side, cross over, step to the side, heel out. Step to the side, cross over, step to the side, heel out. Step, cross, step, heel. Step, cross, step, heel. Step, cross, heel, cross, heel, cross, heel, cross, heel. All right, it's cute if you do it crossing your arms and opening. So step, cross, and out, cross, out, cross, out, cross, out. Okay, so picture that you're in a number. Any of this could be Thoroughly Modern Millie, but it also could be Never Met a Friend Like You. It could be Our Guest. Oh, coming up. Be Our Guest. Be Our Guest. Bop, 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 bop it up. Okay, something, that number from a musical that's real upbeat, big ta-da number. Okay, after scissors, it's called flea hops. Okay, flea hops people struggle with because it's a weight change. What you're really doing is picking up one leg and stepping over, picking up the other leg, stepping over. Up, step, up, step. Now instead of stepping, you're sliding. So you're going slide, 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 slide. Okay? I put on these white shoes so you can see my feet better, but it's a little tricky sliding. But slide, 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 slide. Okay? Flea hop. Falling off the log. Okay? I don't know where this came from, but when I demonstrate it, I think you could picture what it looks like. Think of lumberjacks on, you know, dancing on the logs, like if you've ever seen the movie Seven Brides for Seven Brothers. There it is. Okay, so you're gonna go cross in the front, leap to the side, leap to the back, leap to the front, cross, back, back, side, cross, back, back, and cross, back, back, and cross, back, back. Okay, so I'm gonna travel this way. So I'm gonna go over, kick, kick, front, over, kick, kick, front, over, kick, kick, front, over, kick, kick, front. I'm actually gonna kick off my shoes. This is too hard to do it. But I'm gonna have a collision. Okay, ready? One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Okay? Then we have bells. Okay, bells are called bells because they look like the little clapper part inside of a bell. Some people just call them heel clicks, and they're done different ways. So the most common way is cross over. I'm going to pick up my left foot, and my bottom foot is going to come up to it and click them together and land. So I'm going to cross over, foot up, click, land, cross, click, cross, click. Okay, so do you kind of get the feel that you swing back and forth? And click, and click, and click, and click. Okay, so it sort of swings, 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 swings. Okay. let's see. Let's do an illusion. An illusion is done usually by kind of a fun dance number. Maybe it is a fiddle, ready for love. You know, one of those numbers from Singing in the Rain. When you do an illusion, you squeeze your legs together, okay? And this leg, the right leg, is gonna brush the floor. It brushes, it makes a circle to the right. Brush, 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 brush. I'll do it slow again. So the left leg doesn't do anything. The right leg brushes over, brush over, brush, brush, brush. So from the audience, it looks like your leg is making a circle. Brush, brush, brush. Got it? See how to do it? I'll try it again. I'm looking in the camera. I'm hoping you can see it. Okay. Brush, brush, brush. So if it's quick, it's one, two, three, four. Okay? Usually in a Charleston, you do an illusion. And also in a Charleston, you would do the little knee knock trick. Okay, so knee knock. Your legs have to be slightly apart, okay? And do this with your hands. Let's see. This is my right hand. I'm going to do my right side. So I'm going to cross, open, cross, open. For you guys, if you're doing your right, cross, open, cross, open. Your knees are going like this. Boom, 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 boom. Now when I do it, I'm up on the balls of my feet. Knock, knock, knock. Knock. So the feet sort of, or the knees rebound off of each other. They don't just go together, open, but they go boom, 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 like that. So when you do it, you're going to go boom, cross, and open, and cross, and open. So your knees are doing the same thing every time, but your hands are going, so it looks like you're pushing your legs apart, and then you're pulling your legs apart. Pushing them, pulling them. Push, pull. Oh, the left, the right side would be push, pull. Push, pull. Got it? I'll do it again. And one, two, one, two. Oh, believe me, I've seen people just going like this. Okay? But you really are supposed to cross, pull apart. Cross, pull apart. Okay? And this isn't really a trick, but if we were going to do something like fairly modern, even a swing dance, we might want to do a Shorty George. Okay, I don't know why. Was there a man named George who was short? I'm not sure why, how that was named. But a Shorty George is extend one arm down with the index finger pointed, change, change, change like that. So if you're going to do a Shorty George forward, you're going to keep your legs down in a plie. Plie means to bend your legs. And you're going to go right, left, right, left, right, left. You can do it backwards. Right, left, right, left, right, left. So think of, what's a swing song? Swing, you know, let's see. Da 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 da. That's Bugle Boy. I don't know. What, wait a minute. So, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Some people call it a boogie-woogie step, okay? But it's the real name is it's part of a boogie-woogie style, but the real name is Shorty George. Okay. Now, a little bit of Charleston. Okay, Charleston is so fun. Brandon, we've never done Thoroughly Modern Millie. You know, it would be fun, because I do love Charlestons. Okay, so you're going to take your right foot. The basic Charleston is tap front, step back, tap back, step front. So my right foot is tapping front, it's stepping back, it's left foot is tapping back, stepping front. Your arms swing side to side. So the arms never change. Boom, 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 boom. Okay? They can go big. They can do windshield wipers. Okay? Both work. Okay, so ready? And tap, step, back, step, tap, step, back, step. You can do it by flicking the leg. Okay, so all I'm doing is turning my knee in, turning my knee in. Okay? The faster the music is, the harder it is to do that little twisty thing. But, you know, again, I teach high school kids who only know fast. So, you know, so one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Or you can do it where you're going to kick the leg in the front and do kick, step, tap, step, kick, step, tap, step, kick, step, tap, step, kick, step, tap, step. It can be done to the corners. You know, that looks good. Or, and then you can also do, instead of doing a tap step in the back, you can do a ball change in the back. So now you have kick, step, ball, change, step. Kick, step, ball, change, step. Kick, step, ball, change, step. I think that's more fun. Okay, it gives you a little breath, a little chance to get a breath on that ball change. And it also lets everybody get their kicks up higher. You can also do a kick front, a kick back, a kick front, step. Kick, 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 ball change. Kick, 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 ball change. Okay, so if I was Cheryl at 26, okay, my leg would be here, 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 here. Okay? So, also... Let me think, what else? That's probably the basics. I thought I'd put on a little Thoroughly Modern and we could Charleston a little bit to that. So let me find that. Everybody grab a drink of water, a cup of coffee, glass of wine. But when you do choreography, you have to know a little bit about every style of dance. So I have taken a couple of ballroom classes 50 years ago. So if you are a ballroom dancer, look away. Okay, so we're going to go front step, back, three in place. Back step, front, three in place. Front, back, one, two, three, back, front, one, two, three, one, two, cha-cha-cha, one, two, cha-cha-cha, one, two, cha-cha-cha, one, two, got it? Now you can do it crossing, cross step, one, two, three, cross step, one, two, three. You can do it turning. For you guys, we're gonna do the turn, and then we'll go straight, and then we'll turn and go straight. So we're going one, two, turn around, one, two, cha-cha-cha, one, two, turn around, one, two, cha-cha-cha. Or you can syncopate it and go one and two and three in. So what I'm doing is I'm doing cross, back, back, cross, back, back, close, cross, back, back, cross, back, back, close. Okay, so let's say I'm partner dancing with someone. All right, so I tried to get Mark. No, he just walked out the front door. He said no. So anyway, so the woman puts her left arm on her partner's shoulder and her right arm out to the side. I'm gonna turn this one, okay? The guy puts his left arm, holds her right hand. All right, so if I'm the guy, I'm here. Left hand, right hand, around her back, okay? Now, you've probably heard that the guy should lead. So what that means is he sets the direction for where you're gonna go. Hopefully you both know the steps already, but he pushes and pulls the girl to the next spot, okay? So if I'm gonna be a girl and I'm facing this way. So I have my right arm here, I have my left arm around his neck. Now he's gonna push me backwards first, okay? So I'm gonna go back on my right, step, cha-cha-cha, and I'm gonna go forward on the left, cha-cha-cha, back, front, cha-cha-cha, front, back, cha-cha-cha. Now we can drop hands, okay? And you can do a cross step, cha-cha-cha. Now I usually have the girl be on this side because on the last cha-cha-cha, you would have to go left, right, cha-cha-cha, back, front, close. The girl has to just close. The guy can continue with the cha-cha-cha because now the girl has to start with her left foot. Okay, so now we're gonna go cross step back, one, two, three. I'm holding his hand, step back, one, two, three, cross step back, one, two, three, cross step back. Or you could go one, two, to the back, one, two, turn under, cross step, cha-cha-cha, cross, turn under, okay? Then you can get to that little syncopated part where you either can hold like this or you could hold hands and you go cross, back, back, cross, back, back, close, cross, back, back, cross, back, back, close. Okay? All right, I'll put a little music on and we'll do some cha-cha. This is Sean Mendez, who I desperately want my oldest granddaughter to marry because I think he's so cute and talented and rich. Okay. Ready? Holding on. We're going to step back, girls, with our right foot. Guys, you're going to step forward with your left foot. Maybe I should do the girl side, then the guy side. Okay, here's the girls. And one, two, chop, chop, chop. Now you can add little hips to it. Back and front and cross step, cross step. Now I'm gonna turn on the next one. Cross, turn, okay? All right, so let's do the guy. Okay, so left hand out, right around your back. And boys, you're gonna step forward with your left foot first. Ready? Here we go. Cross, start, cha-cha-cha. Back, front. Now this is your hold, and cross, step, turn. Cross, step, you turn her. Cross, step, back. And now you're gonna turn. One, and two, and three, and four. One, and two, and three, and four. Got it? Or, I promise you to start with the left calf. Left and right, right and left, close. Left and right, right, left, close. Got it? Okay. There's a lot more to Charleston to Charleston. Well, yeah, there is. A lot more to cha-cha, but that's just a basic. So now we're going to do a basic waltz. So a waltz is counted in three counts, right? Three, four time. So everything is one, two, three, one, two, three. And that does throw people off sometimes. So sometimes at the theater, we do a waltz step to 4/4 time, which gives a count for a hold. So I'll explain that in a minute. Okay, but same thing, girls. Same hold as the cha-cha, but now there's like no breaks, so we're gonna go. One, two, three, one, two, three. Back, two, three. Front, two, three. Back, two, three. Front, two, three. Now, usually it's flat, up, up. Flat on your toes. Down on your toes. Down on your toes, okay? So, the guy is pushing her back. So, guys, you have your hand around her. This hand, definitely on a waltz, you want to hold this arm out straight. Okay, so boys, you step forward with your left foot. One, two, three, back, two, three, front, two, three. Now we're going to lead her. We're going to push her front. We're going to pull her and make a quarter turn. Push her front, a quarter turn. Push her front, a quarter turn. Push her, a quarter turn. Then you can just go crazy. Make a big circle. One, two, three. I'm still the guy. One, two, three, one, two, three. Okay? Girls, what am I trying to say? You have to let him push you and pull you with his hand on your back. If you're me partnering, you're probably leading. But, you know, you don't want the audience to know that you're leading. You want him to take control on that. Okay? So, boys, you have to practice. And you also can, when you can go... one, two, three, one, two, three. Girls, turn. One, two, three. You can turn at any time, girls. One, two, three, turn. Okay, turning is a little bit trickier to do. There's lifts in the middle of waltzing, so you could go one, two, three. I'm gonna go backwards. Back, two, three, front. I have my hands now around his neck, and he's gonna lift me up and put me down, okay? So usually on a lift, for beginners, you have both hands on his shoulders. Boys, you're gonna take both hands and you're gonna put them right under their rib cage, or if they're super thin, right on their hips, right at their hip bones, right here, okay? So ribs work too. And you boys, you don't lift her, you push her up, okay? And you must always bend your knees when you're gonna push her up. And you never, ever, ever do it with straight legs, because then you're going to hurt your back from doing that. So you always want to bend down and push. Girls, usually you have to give yourself a little bit of a jump. So when you know he's going to push you up, you're going to down, you're going to plie a little bit, and you're going to lift your body up and a tiny bit of a jump. You don't want to let the audience know that you're jumping. You also, girls, need to be nice and tight. You have to suck your stomach in, keep your body pulled up, tuck this together, okay? So everything has to be nice and solid. I mean, think about lifting a nice frozen, all I can think of is a turkey for some reason. So that goes straight up and down. So if you have wet spaghetti noodles, okay, they're all going to be like this, right? So you have to keep yourself nice and tight. Okay, so let's do a little bit of waltz. We'll do... Cinderella, because that's one of my favorite. Oh no, let's do Storybook. Okay? This is from Jekyll and Hyde. I don't know if you know this show. Okay, so girls, arm up here. Ready, and one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, turn, two, one, sorry, I lost my spot. Turn, two, back, two. Okay, we'll do the corners now. I'll be the guy. And push your front, quarter turn. 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 Here we go. One, 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 one. Spin her under, lift her up, put her down. Got it? All right, if we were doing something very graceful, classical, Girls, you would cross your left leg back. Back this way. Okay. Guys, feet together. Girls would bow. Thank you for that beautiful waltz. Boys would from the waist, then forward. Okay. Okay. Let's do, we just have swing. Okay. Swing, rock and roll. Okay. When we do swing or rock and roll, and we're gonna dance a little to Come On Everybody from All Shook Up. Real swing is counted as toe, heel, rock back, front. So it takes six counts to do the first step of a swing dance. Toe, heel, back, front. Toe, heel, ball change, remember from tap? But it just doesn't work out when you're trying to remember your words, stay on key, and remember the steps. So we swing in eight counts, and I think I've seen so many musicals, and that's what they're doing. So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, close. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, close. You see what I did? I'll face this way. Toe, heel, rock and together. Toe, heel, front, back, front, together. Okay? All right, so 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now, there's just like a 10,000 things you can do. So let's say my partner's standing there, and this is my right hand, and this is his left. So I can go backwards under that hand, and now go forward back the other way, and then we can swing, and we can both turn, picking up one leg like we did yesterday, swing, turn, or we can do swing, hold hands, and now this is covering out the wash rag. So you're both holding hands, you lift up this hand comes up, and down. If you have kids at home, do it with them. Kids love this step. So swing, under. When you're doing it, you just walk. Okay? Then you can also hold right hands. Okay? So let's say he goes under, and now she goes under. Okay? And then he goes under again. Okay? The girl keeps the right hand. The boy changes now with his left hand, and the girl rolls in and rolls back out, okay? So let me be the guy on this. So I'm gonna go under, now she's gonna go under, and I'm gonna go under, I'm gonna change, now I've got my left hand, I'm gonna lean to the right and give her a little tiny bit of a yank, pull her in, push her back out, okay? You can do sidecars. So you're gonna lift the girl up. I'm the guy right here. You're gonna lift the girl up. You're gonna sit her on this hip. You're gonna push her up, sit her on this hip, push her up. Sometimes you put your legs apart. You take her down through your legs, and then you lift her back up again, and she jumps down. Okay, so girls, when you're doing all these lifts, you have to put your arms around his neck, okay? And so when you're lifted, both legs are together when he lifts you. So you sit on this hip, you swing back, pull your knees up behind you, straighten them out, sit on this hip, pull them up behind you, okay? Now he's gonna swing you through his legs, down. So you're gonna be rocked backwards with both legs up like this. And then when he pushes you up in the air, you're actually looking down at him, okay? You can go up in the air with your legs straight up. That's the most exciting to look at, but it's also a little scary. Sometimes, I mean, I used to do swing a lot with Casey Colgan. Anybody remember Casey? And I have gone over his head before, you know, so kind of scary. So, but you want to stop it so that you're going to come back down. Make sure that you come back down. Okay, so let's just do a little bit of swing with the music. Again, this is All Shook Up, Cheyenne Jackson, remember him? Hang on, let me move it over a little. Okay. I'm the girl right here. One, two, back and close. One, two, back and close. One, two, back and close. One, two. Girls going under, back, under, back. Again, front, back, ball change, close. Front, back, ball change, close. He goes under, she goes under, he goes under, she steps out, rolls in, rolls out. He picks her up. Girl sits this way, up, sits this way, up, slides through, pushes up, jumps down. Okay. Oh. Little hand jive. Stop your legs, stop your hands. Hit, hit, roll, roll. Everybody remember that from Greece? Again, slap your legs, clap your hands. Up, up, roll, roll. Greece was really fun, wasn't it? Okay, yeah, now I'm dating myself from when we did Greece. And Barbara L. was the school teacher. That was a really fun show. Okay, so that's it for today. That's probably all that's gonna be for a while. So keep on practicing. If anybody's interested, I can do another video with harder jazz steps and harder tap steps, okay? But that should just get you going. So the next time you come in and you audition, Bill Stalder, I'm talking to you right now, okay? I don't wanna hear that you thought you wouldn't have to dance, okay? In all musicals, I think the lead, the core, everyone has to dance at the audition so we know what we have to work with. I don't look at anybody and go, oh my Lord, you know, we can't use that person. I'm looking at that person and going, oh, he can do this really cute, or she can do that really cute, or she would look really good if the guys lifted her up on this step. So it's not always just about how you dance, okay? My final thing I'm gonna share with you all is, so during this, does everybody have their, oh my God, this is what I need to get through the night cabinet? If you can't see, it's my wine and Jack Daniels. My favorite is a Diet Coke and Jack Daniels. Kids, look away, okay? So Brenda Stalder, I know you have a cabinet like that. Okay, Jason Luden, I hope you're on here because you've asked me for this class several times. Okay, so till next time, bye-bye.